in Black history. Shirley Chisholm was the first African-American woman elected into the House of Representatives. She was elected in 1968 and represented the state of New York. Did you know that?
Knox Media Group Weather. Download our apps today. Music Muscle of the Shoals, 105.1 FM and WKAX 1500 AM. The current temp, 68 degrees. The forecast for this evening, clear skies with a light breeze, 54 degrees. Overnight, cloud-free and somewhat breezy, temperature 46. And then tomorrow, clear skies with a light breeze, the temp 76. On Sunday, partly cloudy. It will be comfortable, temp around 79. We are the Knox Media Group, Music Muscle of the Shoals, 105.1 FM and WKAX 1500 AM, bringing you the beats and the weather on the go.
M, the music muscle of the show. It is 3 minutes after five, and you're in the drive at five. And guess what? It is time for the anime show. I am your host, Montrell, and I got my partner with me,
G-Man,
in the building. We got a special guest with us today. We got my man, Eric Ingram Bates, in the building. And he's going to talk to us, man, and put us up on game that most of us don't even know about and probably should know about. And you're not going to want to miss the show. So hit up your partners, hit up your friends, share our Facebook page, because we are on Facebook and TikTok, and invite the people on in, all right? Want you guys to stick around and stay tuned to the 80 Main Show right here on 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the show.
Money.
Give it up, give it up, give it up, yeah. I've had it. Some people really need it. Give me cash money.
Muscle of the shows. It is now 10 minutes. Well, you know, I got some more to go, but it is 10 minutes after the hour, and it's time for the Anime Show. I'm the host, Montrell. I got my partner,
G-Man.
And we got a special guest in the building, Mr. Eric Ingram Bay. What's going on, my brother?
What's happening? What's happening?
Appreciate Welcome to the you. Show, my yes, man. Sir.
Appreciate it.
This young man, I have been knowing him forever. I know his family well. I've seen him grow, but I've seen him grow in a direction that I never really understood. But I'm very interested in the things that he's doing and the way that he teaches. And I'm a lot of times that we look at people different. And we don't understand where they're coming from is because we don't take time to find out. We don't take time to listen. We don't take time to know, to get to know what they know. You know, you don't have to agree with everything everybody talk about. You don't have to go where people talk about. No one's trying to sell you on anything.
Right.
But what we're here for is to bring information. And that's why I think it's very important that we have someone like Eric on our show that can tell us exactly things that we may not know, we just don't know as citizens of the United States. And tell us a little bit of what we're going to get into. I know you and G talk, so I'm going to let G really ride with this.
Just to rattle off a few things that he's been talking about lately and before, you know what I mean? The latest one I saw was get paid to pay your bills. He also talks about child support set off. How to offset your mortgage and stop foreclosures. He also talks about tickets and the right to travel. So get your paper and your pencil. If you're watching this on Facebook and TikTok, share this right now. If it's somebody that can't watch it right now, let them refer them to the replay on Facebook or the replay on YouTube. Make sure if you go to YouTube to put your email address in the comments, and it's going to qualify to win you a car this year from Knox Media Group.
That's dope.
Well, right now.
That's dope, dope.
Yeah.
Brother Eric.
What's happening?
I want to kind of explain to the people what it is that you found out regarding our people and the law.
First, before I get started, all my people watching this, hit that share button. Y'all know it's about reciprocating that energy. So everybody share, no matter what. I'm about to share with you. Keep sharing. That's how we keep giving. And as long as you keep giving, you know how that goes.
Yeah.
Reap what you sow.
Exactly.
But, man, when it comes to law, man, I think that we forget who actually set the law first. I think that, you know, we were misguided in a lot of ways, but, you know, we already know that right, to benefit right. them in every single type of way. But again,
when you say them, let's the system, white people, let's talk about it.
If I got to put it in a sense, I can't even put a color on it anymore because it's even our own.
Because I have listeners of all colors. I just need right. to, you know.
So I can say the system, the way the system is built.
Okay.
And yes, because this is for everybody. It's more of a status thing.
Okay. So this is what you're giving us is for every citizen, not just black people.
Everybody.
Okay. All right.
And this means no matter where you at on the face of this earth, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It all applies the same.
You know what? I don't know what we're about to get into, but it's already interesting because a lot of times I sit and think it's like everything that God provided for us, who made us start having to pay for it?
Right.
You know what I mean? So, but anyway, go ahead. Yeah.
I think that the first thing, you know, what's the first thing everybody say about the United States, America, whatever? It's all about money.
Money, right.
So we have to realize it's already commercialized.
Right.
We truly understand what 1776, the United States Constitution. They don't tell you 7 years after that they got hijacked. Like they set up a corporation that mimics the true government.
Okay.
And it was called District of Columbia. And that's in
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C. Okay.
But you got to ask yourself, that's a 10-mile radius that it's considered foreign to America.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Because they always say the United States and the District of Columbia.
Right. It's foreign to America. It's owned by the British Crown. Always has been.
Hold on. So that's why, like, the people that live in D.C., they don't get to, they don't have a mayor or anything, right?
Because the national, the United States is its government. The federal, you see what I'm saying? You see how we have, like, the city, all of that.
City of Florence, then we have, yeah.
Yeah, but they don't have that. They actually have the federal government making the rules for them. That's where U.S. citizens even come from. So you got to think, you said, if we all say we're U.S. citizens, so all of us fit in that 10-mile radius?
Wow. So that's like the head of the corporation.
Say it again?
D.C. is like the head of the corporation.
The corporation, man, where we need to focus on.
And United States is basically someone's corporation.
Yeah, it's ours. We're the shareholders.
Let's get into it. Man, you know, I'm liking this already.
Because, like, when you look at it in this sense, like, we have to realize, like, okay, District of Columbia, that's why you have, what, district judges. We vote on the districts. Every state broken down into a district.
Right, right.
And see, people don't realize, like, that's what's controlling this system. It's the District of Columbia doing business as United States.
Mm.
See what I'm saying? That makes a difference now, right?
It does. It does.
So Who are the shareholders of this company?
What makes us shareholders?
What? Because you are, you got to realize, like, okay, what makes us the shareholders of this? You were given a birth certificate, right?
Okay, yes.
And this birth certificate represents your share.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? It's like your stock in this corporation.
Okay.
And then they give you this social security number. We just got to break down the word. Social means the general overall public, right?
Okay.
Security automatically means protection, assurance, and indemnification.
All right.
So if I issue, that sounds like insurance, right?
Yes, exactly.
So if the insurance give you an insurance card with a policy.
Right.
So that's the same thing.
So your birth certificate is like your policy.
Thank you.
And that makes us shareholders to this United States.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right. I'm in it.
So now think about it. Every time, everywhere you go.
First of all, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Let me. I'm loving the way you laying this down. I want to know first, how did you get into it, and where did you get your information?
I got into this by. I met someone, put it like that.
Okay.
And they did something in front of me. They actually went to a car lot, sat down, filled out, you know, like I'm thinking we're going to see the regular thing, the application, this, whatever, right?
Right.
Like, and I'm talking about credit score terrible.
Okay.
Bro, they left out with a whole car with the keys. And I didn't understand it. He was like, he took some tax forms with him, right?
Right.
And they was like, they looked at me and they was like, I said, well, how you do that? He was like, no, I just want you to know it's possible. Go learn how to do it.
That's no, man. No, so, no, bro.
I just want you to
y'all better share this right here, right now. I'm telling you.
So, go learn how to do it, because most people, you try to tell them, they're going to be like, nah, that's not real. You crazy. You tripping.
I'm saying that right now. Like, so you went.
Look, that's why I wanted him here, because everything that he said, he's done it, or he's helped somebody to do it.
Right.
So he got receipts.
So I was following you. I've been following you when you was going through the child support thing.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I saw that episode part, and then I've seen you like stay dedicated to what you do. Right. You know what I mean? So that really kind of got me to looking and trying to want to know more. You know what I mean? So I think that's also after you saw that, you was like, I'm gonna find out.
I gotta find out, because I knew we was lied to then. I realized I got children. I'm like, right. I can't pass this burden on to them to figure it out.
Right.
I'm alive right now. I'm living. I'm you know, I'm in my right mind. Let me do the study and let me put in all the hard work so I can come and show others, you know, this is possible. You can do this. But to where it really starts at, like, we gotta, and I'm saying, like, I'm gonna say it like this, because I grew up in the church.
Right.
My father was a pastor of a church all my life till he passed away.
Yeah.
You know, my background is that.
Right.
If anybody really want to know, that's my background. So right. To me, it has to be real.
Okay.
I was.
So you were. I'm glad you brought that up, because a lot of our listeners, you know, they do want to know. Like, you are. Do you consider yourself a Christian?
Not in the sense how everybody used the word Christian, but am I a Christian? Yeah, I'm a follower of Christ. Absolutely.
Okay, that's it.
You know what I'm saying? Because I understand that Christ fulfilled the law. I'm supposed to be like Christ, is to do the same thing.
Okay.
So that's like all the way I'm here to do. I'm here to fulfill it, bro. Just the same way. Like, a lot of people think it's really done away with, but it's not, because God said my word will last forever. The word is the law.
Right.
We got to get back to who we are and what God made us. God said, I gave you dominion over the earth.
Over the earth, man. So why
you want to give it away?
Right.
So what were we formed from? Genesis 2 and 7 said, I formed you from the dust of the ground. And I breathed the breath of life into you.
Well, yeah.
Which is really spirit and consciousness.
Okay.
Spirit and consciousness is what we are. This flesh was what? It was dead. It told you that. The flesh was nothing.
Yeah.
So spirit and consciousness. So God said that he made, in the beginning was the word. You know, that part right there, right?
Yes.
And then he also said everything that God made was made by God.
Right.
And it had life in it.
Right.
It had life. Listen to what I'm saying. It got life.
Life. Yes.
Life in it. And then he also said that he wrote the what? He wrote the law on your heart.
Exactly.
You know how that's true? Because who writes the law for the corporations? We do.
Exactly.
So that means we automatically already have the law within us. It's already ours.
Man,
we just got to claim it. We got to really walk in it and walk in it in whole. Like, seriously, you got the right to travel. The only reason you need a license is because you're saying you're a taxi cab driver.
Okay.
You drive and Lyft.
Right.
But other than that, you got the right to freely travel abroad.
Right.
Without any restriction.
Do you know that they don't really like people living off the grid.
But I ain't even living off the grid.
I mean, but I'm just saying, like, I've seen, like, it was a couple, I think, in Huntsville somewhere that.
Yeah, they came and arrested them and everything.
They came
off their own land.
They on their own land. They was, like.
Collected rainwater and everything. Like, they was all the way off
but
the
grid. But see, where they mess up is, like, you got a choice. Like, you got to choose who you're going to serve. Like, you either going to, all right, put it like this. What's the First Amendment talk about? Notice it's number one.
Okay.
Religion.
All right.
So we can't even exclude this, because what was these people even running from? They was getting slaughtered for their religion and for their beliefs. You got to think about that. They was getting killed, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So now they made that the base foundation. Your obligation to God is first before society.
Okay.
So that means the truth is, your church was the first government, bro. We gave it away. We went to Caesar.
Mm.
We weren't supposed to.
Okay.
And that takes us back to what? 1 Samuel 8 chapter. God, the people said, hey, we want a king like them. It was like, what? God, I gave
you. Don't need
a
king.
I gave you a sound conscious mind to govern yourselves.
Yes.
What you need a king for?
So tell me this. When did the taxation begin? What is that in the? Is that a Bible thing?
When you decided to play in commerce.
You know, we was talking about this the other day. Yeah. I told you, ain't nothing written in saying you got to pay no taxes.
When you started to play in commerce, like.
Yeah, we was talking, yeah.
You play in commerce. All right, I really have to break this down because, like I say, like, for people to really truly understand this, you got to know what happened.
Okay.
All right. 1933, they went into, like, a form of bankruptcy.
Okay.
That's the reason why every dollar says Federal Reserve note. Well, by law, note means promissory note. It's a promise to pay.
Okay.
All right. So really, there's no money. Money is supposed to be gold and silver. But mm-hmm. what they did was what became the money, you became the money because you monetize everything into United States dollars. So who mm-hmm. actually creates the dollar? We do.
We do.
Our labor, goods, services, and our products.
Mm.
See what I'm saying?
Right.
So the truth is, like, you got to really see that part first. So they said, all right, this is what we're going to do. We don't got enough gold and silver to keep circulating through mm-hmm. this economy. One, why? The United States was broke when they first started, bro. They've been right. borrowing money from everybody. They didn't have nothing
right.
ever. Like, they yeah. don't tell you, but they borrow. George Washington wrote a letter to the Sultan of Morocco. Why would he write a letter to the Sultan of Morocco about him being the chief on this land? That's because it was, that's because, like, people don't understand, like, we talk about territory. That's your territory, right? But we can be in America, but your particular territory belonged to you. Spain right. had territory here. French had territory here. The British had territory right. here. Morocco had territory here.
Okay.
We have to come back to that concept. That's what it was. That's why they say, like, the different, you say Indian territory and all of that. But right. that's their classification. What's your classification? You see what I'm saying?
So yes.
all of that was broken into. But what to get back, what I'm saying is, it's like, okay, they went into bankruptcy. So they was like, all right, this is what we're going to do. When a country go into bankruptcy, they have one or two things to do. They either have to give you their natural resources.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
Whatever they control of. Back then, they had to get their children, their wives, whatever. You got to give something up.
Oh, straight up?
Oh, yes, sir. If you owe debt, a country owe debt to somebody else or whatever, either you're going to marry off your daughter to us. So wow. we can become one, join the kingdom. I get part of your land, etc. You pay me your gold, or you're going to pay me in grain. Whatever you have
right. that's
going to be beneficial right. to my country is what we want.
That's what I got to get.
That's yeah. what it's going to, you know, take for this debt, right? Mm-hmm. So what happens is now we got to look at the United States. What do they have to give? It's a corporation. They don't have the land to give because land belonged to you. God gave it to you. That's the first contract.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
Can't ever forget that. Starts with God first. That's why they ask you for your consent. Remember, the devil had to what? Ask for permission.
That is true.
You gotta think about wow. this, right?
Yeah.
They go all the way back to this. So now they say, okay, well, we got Federal Reserve notes. This is what they create. They create their own money, which is Federal yeah. Reserve notes, mm-hmm. and right. they created a U.S. citizen.
Okay.
And you're not even a U.S. citizen. You just control them. So now I want you to look at this U.S. citizen like it's a servant for you.
Okay, now this goes back to what you were talking about before with the Social Security number.
With Social Security number.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the taking control of your straw man,
exactly.
right?
Exactly.
Okay.
But you are. But see, everybody thinks it's a lot of papers and stuff you got to go fill out to do. But the truth is, it's not. It's just to know. All right. 9/10 of the law says what?
Possession.
Okay.
So if it's in your possession, you own it to prove otherwise that it belongs to somebody else, right?
All right. You're right.
Okay. So the other 10th is like me picking this thing right here, saying this is the title.
Okay.
That's the other 10th of the law that kills out the 9/10 of the law, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
right.
if you have in your possession the Social Security card and the birth certificate, automatically you have control over this U.S. citizen.
Right.
So you control it. Now, how about now what they said was this. Okay, we're going to give you Federal Reserve notes for all public and private debt. And we're going to give you this servant / straw man. Mm-hmm. It's a slave to you, to be honest.
Right.
We're going to give it to you to work off all public and private debt. So everywhere you go, everybody asks you for your what?
Signature.
Social Security number.
Yeah.
Because they want the servant.
Oh, wow.
You see what I'm saying? They want yeah. the servant. Remember, so anything that a king gives you, it's valuable, is it not? So think yeah. about this United States as a king. It gave you his word and value. And even his word, it's value, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you take that. You get to, they gave you a Social Security and a birth certificate.
Right.
There's obligations to this, though.
Okay.
And notice every birth certificate is print on a bond paper, security paper.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
See yeah. what I'm saying? So what happened was the state said, okay, remember, it's a union. So the union states was like, all right, they stamped the bottom of your feet. Mm-hmm. And now we playing commerce.
Okay.
All right. So since we playing commerce, anything in the world is abandoned unless it's in your possession or claimed.
Say that again.
Anything in the world.
Right.
All right. On this earth.
Okay.
It's abandoned unless it's in your possession. You either occupy it. You see what I'm saying?
Right. Okay.
And you have a rights and titles of interest to it, right?
Right.
So they saying when you was born, you came out your mother's womb. And remember, commerce is by the rules of the sea.
Okay.
So international law means really the only law that exists is our contracts.
Okay.
Nothing else. Just the contract.
Just the contract.
I'm only obligated to what I contracted into. Now, there's implied contract, meaning that just by your actions implies you in contract with me.
Right.
Or there's an express contract, like you sign, signature, whatever.
Right.
That's express. So by you using the Social Security, it's implied.
Yes.
Okay. All right? Okay. See what I'm saying?
So okay.
Now, know that much right there. So now when you step in, now all they asking you for every single time is for you to use your servant. You the master of it. You hold the title to it.
Wow.
And and they need to use it to set off the debt. Remember, you out here using it in all your private endeavors.
It's my Social Security.
Right. Number. So remember, take us back, though. You said so. And I don't want people to throw the word around so loosely. We just say Social Security. No, security means protection, assurance, and to be indemnified. Mm-hmm. And whoever gave it to you has to indemnify you.
Tell us what that means.
So it really is a discount. 100% discount. That's exactly what it means.
Whoa.
Yeah. That's why dude was able to go to the car lot.
Okay.
Come out
okay.
With a car.
How do you even get looked at? Like, if I sit down and say this stuff to somebody, they're going to look at me like, what is, man, if you don't get out of here in your credit bag, get out of here. You know what I mean? Like,
but once you start learning this, you're going to start holding up. Because remember, this commerce, so I told you, they stamped the bottom of your feet. They claimed you first.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They claimed your body. So how do you reverse that? We got to go back to the spirit. I'm spirit and consciousness that possess the body first. I got to antecede the claim before you.
Hold up. Look, we're going to get deep, too. You know, I want to take a break real quick. I'm loving this. I need to hear this. I hope y'all tuned in, man. This is dope. Hey, look, I want y'all to stick around and stay tuned to more of the Ain't a Man Show right here on 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the shows.
Jay is hard as hell. Battle anybody, I don't care. You tell. I excel. They all fail. Gonna cocktail double almost.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I to ride and do like this? It's good when you know you're down. A super dope all the way from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such, and this is Beaver. You can't touch it. I told you, homeboy, can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know, can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that, now you know you want to dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire girl and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on, pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that. Like that. Hold on a minute, don't fall on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch. Yo, I told you, you can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? You can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You talk about the hammer, you talk about a show that's hot and tight. Singles are swept so fast, I'm a whiteboard tape. To learn what's it gonna take in the 90s to run the charts. Legit. Either work hard or you might as well quit. That's the word, because you know you can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time. Go with the flow. It is said if you can't move the list, you probably are dead. So wave your hands in the air. Bust a few moves. Run your fingers through your hair. This is it. For when I dare to dance, when your opponent gets there, now move, slide your rump. Just for a minute, let's all do the bump. Yeah, you can't touch this. Look, man, you can't touch this. You better get a hype, boy, because you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. Time. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Break it down. Every time you see me, the hammer's just so hype. I'm dope on the floor and I'm magic on the mic. Now why would I ever stop doing this? With others making records that just don't get. I pull around the world from London to the Bay. It's hammer, go hammer, hit the hammer, yo hammer, and the rest can't go in play. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
You kids get to bed, I get the storybook. Y'all tucked in? Here we go. Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow, when laws were stern and justice stood, and people were behaving like they ought to good, there lived a little boy who was misled by another little boy, and this is what he said. Me and you tonight, we're gonna make some cash, robbing old folks and making the dash. They did the job, money came with ease, but one couldn't stop, it's like he had a disease. He robbed another sister and a brother. Tried to rob a man who was a DT undercover. The cop grabbed his arm, he started acting erratic. He said,
keep still, boy, no need for static.
Punched him in his belly and he gave him a slap. But little did he know, the little boy was strapped. The kid pulled out a gun, he said, why'd you hit me? The barrel set straight for the cop's kidney. The cop got scared, the kid he starts to figure, I'll do years if I pull this trigger. So he cold dashed and ran around a block. Cop radios into another lady cop. He ran by a tree, there he saw the sister. Shot for the head, he shot back, but he missed her. Looked around good and from expectations, he decided he'd hit for the subway stations. But she was coming and he made a left. He was running top speed till he was out of breath. Knocked an old man down and swore he killed him. Then he made his move to an abandoned building. Ran up the stairs up to the top floor. Opened up a door there, guess who he saw?
Who?
Dave the dope fiend shooting dope. Who don't know the meaning of water nor soap, he said.
I need bullets, hurry up, run.
The dope fiend brought back a spanking shotgun. He went outside, but there was cops all over. Then he dipped into a car, a stolen Nova. Raced up the block doing 83. Crashed into a tree near university. Escaped alive, though the car was battered. Rat-a-tat-tatted and all the cops scattered. Ran out of bullets and he still had static. Grabbed the pregnant lady and pulled out the automatic. Pointed out ahead, he said the gun was full of lead. He told the cops, back off, for honey, here's dead. Deep in his heart, he knew he was wrong. So he let the lady go and he starts to run on. Siren sounded, he seemed astounded. And before long, the little boy got surrounded. He dropped his gun, so went the glory. And this is the way I have to end this story. He was only
17
in a madman's dream. The cop shot the kid, I still hear him scream. This ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about the wrong path. Straight and narrow or your soul gets cast. Good night.
Knock him out the box, Rick. Knock him out, Rick.
Ooh, boy. That Uncle
Knock
Ricky
out the box,
is really weird. Out,
crumbs.
FM, the music muscle of the shows. It is now 5:42, and you are tuned into the Drive at 5 and the Andy Main Show. I'm your host, Montrell, and I got my partner,
G-Main,
in the building with our special guest today, Mr. Eric Ingram Bay, and he is putting us up on game. All right, now, Eric, let's get back into it, and let's start where you want to. Because
I'm so into maritime law.
Maritime. All right.
Okay. Maritime. Like, so I guess the last thing I was saying that this is commerce. Everything is it's for sale.
Right.
On this land, like, it's basically for grabs. Everything is considered in an abandoned situation.
Okay.
And literally, if you occupying it, just like you occupying the space right now, you know the word, move your feet, lose your seat.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing. You move your feet, you lose your seat, unless you got a title to it.
Okay.
Right. So I want y'all to think of, because a lot of people like to say, oh man, they got us in captivity. We slaves to the system. No, you're not. Think about Django.
Okay.
Django, as soon as the movie come on, the white dude shoot the people he looking for, you know, he looking for Django, right?
Right.
Killed one, left the other one alive. The only reason he left the other one alive was to finish the business. So he did the contract, end up giving him the title. He sold Django. So he gave him the title to Django. All right. So what did the white dude do right after that? He gave Django the title
to himself.
Thank you. So that made him what?
Free.
Thank you. So do you not got the title to yourself?
Yes.
Wow.
So you're free. But here's the thing, though. You cannot act as the individual person in this system. Okay?
Okay.
Because in this system, remember, that's a slave.
All right.
That Social Security number, it's a worker, bro. It's going to get worked.
That's like your avatar.
Yeah, that's your avatar.
And say where you working at, where you at all times.
Yeah, yeah. So I want you to look at it like you got control of this. So now, remember, we got to play this game, too. We can't not play this game. If you either going to play or get played.
Right.
As in anything, right?
Right.
So you got to play the game. And the way to play this game is, right, all right, the first thing that was given to you, again, and the reason why this maritime stuff work is because they considered the woman the mothership.
Okay.
And what the first thing she happened? Her water broke. All right. So now the child's coming down through the canal, same way they do in a ship, right?
Okay.
And then now the mother, where she went? She went to the dock, which is the doctor.
The doctor. Oh, okay, wow.
Right.
Okay.
All right. Then the mothership, once it opens up, all right, then the child comes down the canal, is considered to be what, crowning, right?
Right.
So yeah, the same thing a ship do, right?
Right. Exactly.
So now I want you to look at this child coming out. And when the child come out, it's the same thing as goods coming out of a ship. So now what was the value of this good? So they did what? They weighed you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You see what I mean? And they what? Measured you. That's the same thing you do with what? Money.
Yeah.
You got a real weights money. Yeah. Real money is weights and measures.
Mm.
So that's oil, gas, like you said, gas, minerals, barrels of gas. All, that's like really considered like the real resources of money. So now you got to think about you.
Mm-hmm.
You are minerals.
Okay.
You are gas. You are liquid. You are this. You're everything on the periodic table to some form of degree. Mm-hmm. You got some percentage of it in you.
Right.
All so
right.
You can find right. that. So therefore, you yourself are what? Resourceful.
That's true. Right.
So now they said that you were worth your weight and your measurement in gold. Why you think they weigh and measure you every time you go to the hospital? Because they checking on their what? They asset.
They asset. Wow.
They want to. You gain interest. Why you think they weigh you when you die?
Right.
Because you gain interest. And they give you a death certificate, another security for your
family. Never thought, the average person does not think about any of this stuff. Like, we just go along. We get along. We don't really understand. Then we get afraid when people like yourself tell us things like this. You know what I mean? Like, oh, that boy crazy. Don't listen to that stuff. Or, you know what I mean? Like, they rather just stick to what they know.
I respect that. But once the receipts come out, it's cognitive dishonesty.
Because I've been interested, and I see you on the internet. I see all the followers you have. I see how many people that actually communicate back and forth with you and comment on things. So they really, like, people really listen. You really have good information. So that's another reason I'm learning myself right now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm glad you're here. So tell us more about that.
All right. Yeah. So we got to flip the game. Remember, you ain't really supposed to be doing nothing in your name. Remember, do not. The name is sacred.
I know.
If you do anything in the name in vain, you see what I'm saying? It's going to cost you. So don't become, even God said, don't become the surety for another. So why would you become the surety for this particular government and you're not?
Okay.
It owes you. You don't owe it. See what I'm saying?
Right.
Because again, the first contract is the first contract is with God, but the contract that deals with all us overall, as shareholders, is the Constitution.
Okay.
The Constitution said only gold and silver can be considered lawful money. Are you getting paid in gold and silver in any of your labors?
No.
So since we not, that means now this will breach a contract. How did they fit? They got to fix this. So HJR 192, the first thing it says is resolved. So they resolved the issue by giving you that Social Security number and putting out these Federal Reserve notes. But again, so how do we stop this again? So we got to realize that this commerce, everything is abandoned unless you are occupying and got some type of claim to it, right?
Okay.
So now you got to take that birth certificate, claim it, put it in a trust. I don't know how many people know about trust, but you need to put it in a trust.
Okay.
All right. And you need to convey it to the trust. The trust will outlive you.
Mm-hmm. So hold on. Say that again. Take your birth certificate.
Yes.
and put it in a trust.
Yes. And your children's too.
Explain that.
Because now you're claiming the body.
Okay.
What type of trust? Because I know.
Yeah, talk about the trust part.
The trust, I mean, it really don't really matter because the trust is as a whole is an entity that has the right to have ownership. But anything that goes into the trust, it has to be monetized.
Okay.
So now I can put, if I put this birth certificate, and a birth certificate is called a certificate of security or a certificate of security, which means it's a title to a bond.
Okay.
So now this particular, now we need to claim that because if you don't, then it's, remember, you only acting as an individual. You got to make something that's going to show a form of separation in that. So it needs to go in a trust. Or some people say, hey, the big thing is go get an LLC and start operating and do the same thing you do with that, because you want to make a separation of that. Because once they see you operating as an individual, it's a taxpayer. It has to pay taxes.
Exactly. Okay.
You see what I'm saying? But when you move in trust, it's different now. Because now your trust can be governed by your church laws.
Mm-hmm.
And now,
who knows this? Like,
the state can't interfere. That's with your children, whatever. Like, they child support, they can't even, they can't even, you see, they're not even competent when it comes to your religion. The only thing is you don't express it. So everything is under presumption. I'm under the presumption that you always out here in business.
Okay.
No matter what.
Right.
So that's why I was saying when you go to the store, you buy a candy bar, they under the presumption that you're finna go resell that candy bar. That's why you was taxed.
Mm. Oh, okay.
See what I'm saying? But the truth is, if you're not, you're not supposed to pay that tax. That corporation is the one profiting on your land. See
so, well, speaking of tax, right? So, when they tax us, like how we get taxed like twice, I guess. So,
because
they take taxes out of your paycheck.
Right.
And then when you go buy something, it's taxed.
But why don't you take that paycheck and put it in the trust? Now they can't tax it because now that money is being used for another specific purpose. Now your whole life should be about your ministry. So if it's about you, if you, every, all of us are in ministry right now. Everything everybody doing is a form of ministry.
Right.
You should look at it like, you should.
I did not know that. I never looked at it like that.
But you should, you have to.
Okay.
Because then once you start doing that, now you're going to start seeing the difference because now, like, that child of God, like, how you gonna tax me? You can't tax me. We in a different form of jurisdiction, is what I'm saying.
Okay.
They don't have that. Remember that no taxation without representation. So the state can't represent the church.
Right, because they're separated.
We're separated.
Right, but then the First Amendment say they can't, one, they can't create a law to prohibit you from exercising your religion, nor can they make one religion greater than the other. So now for it, it doesn't matter as long as your religion doesn't cause harm to others by taking away their rights to serve.
Okay.
So the only way that only place that actually happened that is at what, like a high, like a school or something like that, because you gotta think about it. If a Muslim, Christian, a Buddhist and all of them trying to pray, like, well, Christians pray, we pray a different way. Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? And like Muslims, we know, and I say that because I feel like I'm connected to all. I feel like God put his word abroad all over the earth.
Right.
Yes.
So
I agree with you.
With that being said, like they all got a different way they pray. So it'll cause a conflict. So now the state has to step in to neutralize that. That's the only way they step in when it comes to religion.
Right.
But to take us back to that, like back to the commerce part, like now you got your body. It belongs to God. God gave it to you first. That's a contract. You got to make that claim first. Your name was given to you. So now everything you put into the trust, you get to value your name. How much is your name worth? Go trademark your name.
Oh.
You see what I'm saying?
Right. Okay. Yeah,
trademark
okay.
Trademark your name. It's yours.
And own my name.
Yes.
So we don't know that we don't really own our names.
It's because, no, because anybody can use it. Think about it. Your name is being sold information. Who just got in trouble for AT&T? Somebody else? I think
selling information?
Yes.
That's what they say TikTok trying to do.
Yeah.
As if they're not already doing that over here.
They sell it. So you need to monetize. That's why I say let's play the game too. So let's monetize our name. Even your address. I'll make it to where you can't even send me no mail without permission. Like, you send me something, you got to pay me.
Wow. Man, get out of here, Eric. No.
It's for real.
Hey, y'all listeners, man, this is something special. I hope y'all tuning in for real.
What y'all say earlier?
As for what?
They selling water
air.
Yes.
So jump grapes, in the game.
Apples. Grapes, apples.
That God gave us for free.
You grow. But you know what's crazy? Somebody's like, growing your own food is literally dirt cheap. You know what I mean? Like, I'm surprised they don't tax people for gardens. Like, for real.
They do.
Do they?
Yep. If you let them.
Yeah.
They tax you for whatever. But I'm just saying, like, what makes the difference is, like, you know, really jump in the game and understand, like, they selling your information. How is you not selling, making them? You see what I'm saying? So if you give everything to the trust get to come around, like, all right, let's say I did a contract with you, G. All right. And I gave you my social, everything mm-hmm. like that, right? You're going to be my trust, right? Let's say you the trustee over my trust, right?
Right.
I just made you the trustee over the trust. And in the trust, the name is in there, the address, the social security, all of this is being monetized.
Right.
What you're going to do is okay, you get a bill. And when you get that bill, you're going to go to this company as the trust.
Okay, I'm the trust, right, okay.
You're going to go to G and say, hey, man, we see you over here using trust property.
Ah.
So, yeah.
You using that man's name, using... Yeah.
So the trust job.
His address. You're sending them. Yeah.
The trust job is to leverage those assets because it's the assets of the trust now.
Man. Oh, man. Mm-hmm. Come on,
you
man.
You know what I'm saying? So now you got to pay me for the use of my name for every occurrence. So how many times did you put my name on?
Oh, my old lady listening. You know we're coming home. I'm going to go on and do that, right? But yeah.
You know, how many times do they use your name on a bill? How many times do they use your address on a bill?
Every day.
Think about that.
Yeah.
They selling it. Why you not? Now, the thing is, they're
selling our information, right. But we can't sell our information.
You can.
And this is how you get paid to pay your bills.
Oh, snap, man. Come on, bro.
This is so great, man.
I'm loving this. Hey, y'all give us a call. If y'all have a question for Eric, man, or me, or G-Man, give us a call. My number is 256-365-1000, man. If you have a question, this would be the perfect time to get them answered, like straight up. Want you guys to stick around and stay tuned to more of the Ain't a Man Show right here on 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the shows.
Y'all ready for this?
And it comes to 2, 3, and 4. Then I drop the beat I have in store. Lay the lyrics on the top like a rock. Make it sound smoother. Later, make a dub. Enunciate well so that you can tell. I am not illiterate. No, not even a little bit. Nothing like an idiot. Get it? You want the record? Cool, I'm with it. Let the rhythm trip you. Shake it cause it makes you. As I turn the knob to the door, you will escape through. Going like a gnat, don't be a pup. And I let it play cause dress ain't funky enough. Rasta. That's the smooth lyrics that take place. If you want another reason why it must be funky, yo, I am not a jackass, meaning not a donkey. So I will play the game like it should be played. Drop the funk and do the mix so the face will never fade. Ship it to the station in your jurisdiction. Brothers say I'm dope and the others think I'm bitching. No crowd can avoid the deal to the C. Wanna be O-R-4-I-M-I-N-G on the stage. See the simple fact is I am dope and known. I rock a funky beat without a corto. And it's my conclusion. You will enjoy the fusion. And I will ascend with the style that I am using. Knowing that it's a cup, finish not a buff up. I think I'll let it play cause it's a fucking enough. Hip-hop. I can't forget. Make the funky hip-hop music, so check it. Listen to the kick, popping with a click. And with no rehearsals, I'm popping funky verses. Stupid with the visuals, I think that you are relying on. You love it when it battles with the fact that I am buying on suckers. Never come close, cause of knowing. Bevel stuff in the dock when I am going. But in the event, someone would try to juice this, stop him in his tracks, show him that I am ruthless. I don't give a damn, don't think that I am joking, cause I don't think he is funny when you're messing with my money. It's stupid, tell me this, your Trey, you gotta stop him, but with no frills, so I just drop him. Continue with the rhyme and make sure I get mine with no static, cause it's something I send G to get my nine. But lessons I've been learned, now I get it on the front and let it play. When the people say, Trey, oh, you're a fucky and now. Let's get it funky. With the deal to the sea. I need a break so I can check around. See who the hell that is sitting down. I want all chairs off the floor. And if he stands to the wall, show him the door. And I'll be getting a beat to give you something to rock to. I don't not stop to, not to look at the fact you perceive. But can't believe you're being taken. Why be so cool, you start shaking and shivering. Cause I'm delivering the answer. Haven't seen if you're a hell of a dancer. You try and say it, but it just won't work. Cause the beat is so rough. So tell me, tell it, don't be funky enough. And with the help of the Dr. Dre, kick it.
I used to think about immature things. You know, like, do you love me? Do you want me? Are you gonna call me like you said you would? Is this really your real phone number?
Get money. New money. Hey, rich boy sitting there. All the writers wanna check. Tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac.
A lot of hoes give me their numbers, but I never call. A real OG, like a VIP, and see a player ball. Then after we hit the club, baby, I'ma hit them draws. Yeah, I'ma break you all. That's all. Every freak should have a picture of my on their walls. So low, don't hold me to click, yeah, just for my dog. Yeah, gangsters, hustlers, racers, busters.
Wait a minute.
Bitch, what's selling it? All the haters wanna check. Tight, no slick, just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac. Hit the block, throw some D's on that bitch.
some new shit. $1,000 whips, kind of spraying how I feel. Put your gator on the rear, got peanut butter, ice cream, Peter Pan seats. Just got a fresh cut, now we're looking for the freaks. Take a pair of yellow, make a drop, them balls. I'ma show you how to bow, man, to the law. So, them sweat, they wanna do, hiding on the bread. Cause my legs skate, 22, when I pull up, I'ma park right at the front door. In my club, you got in my, I'm a real pimp. Try it red like a trick. Just bought a new leg and put the fines on that rich boy selling that. All them haters wanna check. Tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac. Just bought a Cadillac. Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy selling that. All them haters wanna check. Tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac. Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch. Just bought a Cadillac. 40. Gonna sprinkle some of you fools with some of this G-A-M-E, man, some of this guy. Understand my system. Gonna sprinkle you fools with my sprinkler system. Understand this stuff. It don't stop you when you go from I'm off the Glock, I'm off the 6R. P226, Diana Ross, Cousin Nina, Misdemeanor. That's what we do, understand it. I'll be more hipper than the hippopotamus. Get off in your head like a neurologist. Push him awake to Atlas. Gotta fight about the name of Tupaculus. The 707, my risk go hella fall back to floor terrace. Yeah. I pull a 40 out of my bark after then I flush it down my esophagus. The group that I'm with, the click, like Sugar D shot legit. Family orientated, game related, it's the family. Ish, crucial. Sitting them down mutual. Running through these lyrics as if I was fiber, like Metamuso. Timer. Holy water, holy water. Sprinkle me, man. 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 Big timer, timer. Big time. Holy water. Sprinkle me, man. 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 Kick the shit, shit.
Here comes the top notch. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Here I be. Clicked out me. Shook the tea from the beat. I'm quick to smile.
Quick to smile.
Always down for the job. You gotta strut. That's a gang shot.
Gang shot.
Ooh, ooh.
Sugar, sugar,
oh, yeah,
sugar,
me.
Sugar. That's my sister.
You know my name.
Sprinkle me, girl. 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 Sugar, sugar.
That's what they call me.
That's my sister.
I ain't right.
Sprinkle me, girl. 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 Sprinkle me, girl.
Check the location.
Taking VH on a player making mega. Trying to knock the hustle just because we way too major.
He's ain't trying to test your test. You know that
Annie's
cool.
Sugar don't make me have to come about the sound booth and act
a fool. These old hoe-cake ass niggas, they make me so damn sick.
Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom on the trick.
Play a player for false and get rubbed off. You don't want more, so I want more. We're gonna get evaporated. Cause I'm a timer, 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 timer. Body water. Sprinkle me, 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 man. Big timer, timer,
big time.
Body water.
Body water.
Sprinkle me, sprinkle me, sprinkle me, sprinkle me, sprinkle me, sprinkle me. That's what we do. Understand it. Understand it. What's happening, shit? You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sprinkle and me, we are back. 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the shows. And we are doing the Drive at 5 and the Anime Show. I'm the host, Montreal, and I got my partner,
G-Man,
in the building. And it is a great day because we have someone here in the building that's like putting us up on game, man. putting us up on some real game. Want you guys to tune in, gather around your radio like they did in the old days, or just tune into us on Facebook and check us out at Knox Media Group. But we got Mr. Eric Ingram Bay on the show with us today. So, Eric, how are you and everything? How's everything going, my man?
Everything beautiful, man. I can't complain, bro. God is great.
Well, good. We really appreciate you coming in and putting us up on this. I just, like, took a little break, so I just went outside, and Janet was like, that is amazing. Like, the information you're giving, like, she really... Because no one knows this stuff. Like, for real. The average person doesn't.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, let's get back into it, y'all.
Where we at,
G-Man?
Let's see. We were at,
I was the trust.
Yeah.
And we was going from
Okay, right.
See, I'm tripping on getting my name trademarked.
Right.
I'm getting my name trademarked.
Getting paid to pay your bills.
Absolutely. Y'all, this is the real deal now, because I do want to let the audience know, Eric is not just here saying this. I'm pretty sure he's put all this into works. Like, he's really doing what he's telling us to do.
Absolutely.
Yeah, okay.
I really do this free on Mondays and Wednesdays anyway, so I have classes and just to teach people, and we do this together and just to really experience – gain the experience so people can know it's for real. You know? Like I didn't help people get felonies gone.
Wow.
You know, $100,000 child support, you know, any tax say any.
Man, IRS I wish tax. I had a new you wave. I knew you know I wish I'd saying. Have been doing this though. I'd have been a Eric Basie.
Oh man, look, hey, we just gonna but see, this is what people don't even know, even when it comes to child support. Let me explain this to you. Like, the Child Support Enforcement Agency has a contract under Title 4D with the judge.
Okay.
The clerk, the sheriff, any private investigator, whatever they send to find you. Even the people, they got what they call like the new, it's like a company, like any new hire, they have to report to them for like child support reasons. Like, they even pay them. So when you go into this contract, you paying people.
Yeah.
It's not for you, just your child. You paying off everybody.
That's crazy. I thought about that too. And then I also thought white people don't pay child support.
So look,
every time I go down there, it's all black people.
Right.
But go ahead.
But so look, check this out. Yeah. What get it is, like, anything the judge has an interest on, he can't be on the case.
Oh.
But he got paid in a child support case.
Right.
So you can recuse a judge off a child support case just by him even having a contract and receiving compensation. You got an interest in it. That's illegal. Can't do that. You can't sit on the bench and have an interest in a case. That's just
who knows that if you who do you even bring that up to, Eric? Like, hold up, judge. This is how this works. I mean, like, yeah, throw him in the slammer till he pays.
Nah, for me, I'm gonna tell you my situation. This was back in 2000, I would say 19. I went to jail for child support, right?
Okay.
And they told me either do 250 days or pay $5,000.
Hold up. See, that's crazy too. Why are you gonna be in jail? No one is helping no one. Like,
it is, because you gotta remember what happened to that body. They got their body. So their body, they're going to use it. They're going to use it to monetize it at $1.25 in prison or whatever. Like,
so that's why they're locking us up, because they still going to eat.
Yeah, it's monetizing. They took you as property. You volunteered to go.
Okay.
So let me use the word volunteer. You volunteered.
Okay.
So you volunteered. They take your body because, remember, the body was the first thing that was placed in their trust.
Okay.
When you were born, right?
All
right. So they take it. And remember, if you didn't claim it, they claimed.
They claimed.
Right?
Oh, snap. Right.
So now they get to take their property and monetize it.
Okay.
And turn it into United States dollars.
Okay.
So now that's the reason why everybody that's locked up, like, they getting you getting paid to be there, but it's the bare minimum.
Right. Wow. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you there, but it's the bare minimum of that. You know what I'm saying?
So, yeah.
That's the situation. They being compensated, though, everybody.
So get back to the child support thing, because I'm vested.
Well, if you, like I say, but you can go back, though. You can go back since you've been paying it. And you can make them give you every single dollar you ever kicked out. You know what I'm saying? And this is based on you having this knowledge of knowing. Because, again, I don't care. Like we was just talking about with just the trust, right?
And
whatever. So, like, we'll say he the child support enforcement agent. You the trust.
Okay.
We'll do him the same way. How long? All right, I found out you've been using this name for the past 20 years.
Right.
Or however long you've been paying child support. I found that. Yeah. And then not only that, you have your child estate, too. The birth certificate of your child.
Right.
It belongs to you. They don't have possession of that.
Right.
What I'm saying? Right. So they got it. Now I need them to show me delegation of authority. Show me where you were given authority to operate over this property. Especially, remember, we're supposed to put everything in trust anyway.
Okay.
So now if they can't prove that, it's really a breach of trust. It's also considered theft of property. It's also considered, we can go on and on. Like, you can't. Wow. And then since this is a court, the Fifth Amendment says that they cannot take your private property and use it for public interest without just compensation.
Mm.
So you got to pay me.
So tell me this, Eric. So you did this in child support court, right?
Okay, well, yeah, you were talking about 2018.
Well, the way I did it was this. Like, I went, like, and this is before I even got to where I'm at now.
Okay.
I went in, and this is how I really discovered trust. They told me to, either pay them $5,000 or 250 days. And I said, I'm not doing either one.
Okay.
And they was like, well, you ain't going to be able to. I said, so I need to see a judge. They was like, you don't get to see a judge. I said, what? I said, I got y'all. I said, according to your law, I got 72 hours.
Right.
If you don't put me in front of a judge, then you really holding me for nothing. You can't just hold me for nothing. I have to be brought forward because the magistrate has to make sure that you have a reason to even to put me here in the first place.
Right. Okay.
But they were supposed to take me to the judge as soon as they arrested me. That's what I know now.
Oh,
don't take me straight to the judge, that's false imprisonment.
Whoa.
All right. But they had me in there and I told them, whatever. So it took about a week, but they didn't know I had people on the outside.
Okay.
So I had people on the outside doing stuff for me, operate my trust.
Right.
Sent them something, sent the child support enforcement agency something. I went into a whole different separate.
So they got you locked up now?
Yeah, I'm locked up.
Okay.
But I had them do, because you're my trustee, so you can operate over my affairs. So I had them do something for me on the outside and went into a whole separate contract with my ex-wife.
Okay. Right.
So they did a contract with her. And then that brought that into trust.
Okay.
Then guess what? They brought me to court.
All right.
All right. So now when I get, they filed everything for me on my behalf. Now I got a court date.
Okay.
All right. So I was in there a total 17 days. Right. So I get a court date. They come in there and they was like, all right, you're here for whatever. And, you're going to pay the $5,000 or whatever. And I was like, no, I'm not paying it. I was like, I got a trust. Everything is in trust. You guys don't have any delegation of authority over the property in the trust. Y'all not proving any form of jurisdiction,
right?
Which means that you got to show me you have a contract with my trust.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
If you don't got that,
they're listening to you lay it down like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, oh yeah. They let me speak and say what I had to say. But so I said, so since y'all in here using trust property with unauthorized, I need to know who I need to hold accountable. Guess what everybody did in there? Went to point at each other.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? So they went to point at each other, right?
Wow.
And the judge called us up. He called me up to the front and he was like, he had my trust up there. He was like, this right here. He was like, you see this right here? He was like, I know what you're doing.
Yeah.
But it ain't me. It's him.
Wait, who he pointing
at? He was pointing at the one of the people that was like supposed to be the head of the child support.
Yeah, okay. Right.
So
right.
He pointed at him. He was like, it's him. And I was like, I said, yeah, but you allowed it.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Like, you're supposed to protect my, according to the Constitution, you're supposed to protect all of my rights in here now, right?
Right.
Especially after I've expressed that.
Right. Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So now there can't be any presumptions. I've laid down my status to my property here, right?
Okay.
All right. Now, if you want me to authorize you to use it so you can pay off the debt, cool. Because remember, this is my servant.
Okay. All right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
All right. So I tell you.
So how's the judge looking when you laying it down?
I mean, he discouraged because the truth is, it puts them in a frenzy. He know that.
Right.
So they told me, Right after I got done talking, bro, they told me, all right, well, you got to go and go back. They's like, are you not going to pay the $5,000 today? Because he was like, well, you got to talk to them. So they was trying to make a contract, an offer again.
Right.
It's just the offer.
Right. You don't have to accept it.
Because all of, now I know all I had to do is say, this will cause me harm.
Right. Oh, okay.
See what I'm saying? Because you can't, no, you're not supposed to be in any contract that's going to
cause you harm.
So all I got to say is this will cause me harm if I agree to this offer.
Right.
Well, at that time, I just told them, nah, I'm not paying it. I just want to know who I need to make responsible. And they told me, all right, well, if you need to talk to anybody, you need to talk to him. They gave the head of the child support. He sent me gave me his information or whatever. I went back to jail.
Right.
They put me back in there. I think about 4 or 5 days the day before Kobe died.
Okay.
4 or 5 days before that, bro, I was out.
Oh, yeah, they let you on about it
on a Friday.
What they say, like, you was
nothing. I got out. They came and they sent it over and told them to let me out. My folks came and picked me up, and I went home.
Wow.
And then the thing about it, it was going off of my it was going off my credit report, everything. But the thing is, what I be telling people, like, they not even going to admit what I did though.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? They never not going to admit it. They're going to make it look like it was something else. Remember, they told me 250 days, $5,000, no court. Okay. Now I go from all of that to I'm out.
Wow. You're right.
No money, no nothing.
Man, that's some good stuff to know.
Right.
Hey, man. Boy, you know, oh, man. I'm like really tripping off this.
But now it's a better way though.
Okay.
So now I know how to make sure everybody get paid.
Let's talk about that part.
The mama, because it goes.
So the mama and the child, everybody can get paid.
Though. Yes, absolutely.
How does that work?
Using your property. It's your property, your child, your property. God bless you with that. They can't even have it. Now, once you mention God, they can't even comprehend that no more. It's out of their jurisdiction.
Wow.
It's over with.
So. When did you start really letting people like want to be like everybody should know this?
When I mean like just a lot of stuff I've been through, because like even now, like I ride on my own tags.
I saw your tag.
That's
what
I was gonna ask about next, the right to travel.
Let's
get into the right to travel.
I ride on my own tags and I do it under religious autonomy, and that's that God gave me the right of locomotion, the right to freely travel in any shape, form, or fashion. Like, I have that right. Nobody can stop me or restrain me. Now, you can. It's going to cost you.
Right.
I ain't tripping. I don't argue with these folks or nothing. I let them do what they're going to do. Have I ever been stopped before? Yes, I got stopped.
That's what I was going to ask you. They stopped. Like, what kind of tag is this?
I got stopped one time, bro. And I think it was more so for...
you them, being black.
It was what? Just for them to see, bro. Like, it wouldn't even...
They just wanted to know what it was.
Yeah, like, but they pulled me over. It was a state trooper. Pulled me over. It was on Easter, matter of fact. They pulled me over. They was trying to, like, run my name, everything, ask me about my tag, my car, who do it.
Because you don't have an actual Alabama driver's license.
No.
What kind of driver's license do you have?
I don't have a driver license at all, because driver license means you're in occupation to do some form of business. You was given a permit to do business. Mm-hmm. I'm not in business. I'm not in commerce, so I don't need that. But what I do use is I use the passport to travel, because the passport automatically say you have the right to travel the land, air, and water.
Okay. Because I couldn't get my passport because I owe on child support.
Oh, man. But guess what, though? That takes away your right to travel. So they have to get that to you. They can't use that against you, bro.
For real?
Hell no, they can't. They take away a right, so they can either pay you for taking away your right.
Man, get out of here.
I'll give you the right, bro.
Because I messed up some work overseas because I couldn't get my passport.
Nah, man, we can settle that away right now. They can't do that.
Wow. I hope y'all tune in and listen, man. I'm telling you, because this man dropping some gems right now.
Okay, state trooper.
Right.
Okay. Yeah.
State trooper, they pulled me over. He just, you know, just asked me questions, and I said, "Man, I'm just expressing my God-given right. I'm just expressing the First Amendment. You know what I'm saying? And the third Amendment in Alabama Constitution and the 622nd Amendment." And he was like, "Okay, all right, I understand what you're saying. So he was like, well, what you're going to have to do is you need to get you some license. I was like, no, I don't need no license. So I pulled out all the laws that has been already been decided by the judges. Like,
okay.
The past years.
So like, you got to ride with your paperwork?
I don't know, but I did then.
Okay.
Like, you know, and I gave it to him, and he read it. He was like, yeah, man, these laws is over and done with. I said, well, why you got that badge on?
Right.
Like, who, like, just the, like, now I fear you. I'm in fear for my life. And I told him just like that, because mm-hmm. you not a respected person of the law like that.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because now you just told me that your badge don't mean nothing. You're right. Not going to stand under
the
law itself. After you've already seen that this is called informal common law. That means the judge has already judged on it. So this is so.
Okay.
It's already ruled.
Right. Right.
You see what I'm saying? So they end up going through what they did. They took me to jail. On a Sunday, mind you.
Okay.
I'd never forget. I posted the picture that I was in jail.
Yeah.
I was out in 5 minutes.
Get out of here. how that work? Like,
I was out in 5 minutes, bro.
Oh, right? That's great.
Because that's a form of kidnapping, right?
Yeah, yeah. Like,
so for real?
Yeah, because I get in there and I tell them, I was like, look, I was like, well.
What was they locking you up for in the first place?
Because, okay. They locked me up because of the child, bro. They said I had some child support left. Mind you, that's been over. I beat that.
That's over with.
Yeah,
all right.
That's been over with. So they said, now, mind you, child support deal with the county, right?
Right.
Bro, they took me to Sheffield City Jail. I said, how y'all gonna take me to Sheffield City
Jail
for child support?
Yeah, that was foul.
I said that don't add up right. You know this wrong.
Yeah.
I said that don't even sound right to you. Y'all know child support is county.
Right. Right.
Yeah, they took me anyway. I have my wife circle back around.
Uh-huh.
She came back, brought like $300-$400 up there. Mind you still ain't supposed to get out on a Sunday.
Right. Yeah, that is true.
So I get out. We paid them a little extra money, but on the what's name, I wrote some stuff on there, right? So
right.
Now, on every ticket, it's a contract. It's a bond.
Okay.
I put pay to the order of the United States Treasury. I put my Social Security number. I signed it, and I put register on it.
Not your name.
Huh?
You didn't sign your name. You just wrote.
No, I did, but what? I signed as the registered owner.
Okay. Okay.
Because even your Social Security number on that line,
right,
on your Social Security card, it says authorized representative in very small print. That's that little line that you're supposed to sign on.
Okay.
So now, if that says that you are authorized representative, what that mean? Now that made a separation between you and this entity. Because how are you authorized? You can't be the entity if you were representing it. You get what I'm saying?
Right. Right.
So, you know, that's how I signed off. So I had to end up having to go to court. The lady was like, she said some crazy stuff, y'all. Like, she was just like, you know, I watch her go through everybody.
Just the judge?
Yeah,
or?
The judge. She, matter of fact, she retired from over there now. But she said,
so this in Sheffield?
This in Sheffield. So she was like, you gotta do, how she explained it, like, She was really trying to get me to subject myself to what she was saying. She wanted me to just go ahead, agree, or pay for it and get it out the way.
Right.
And I was like, the officer wasn't there.
Right.
I was like, I'm a motion for the case to be dismissed for the lack of evidence. Because if the officer ain't there, well, you ain't got nobody.
Right.
She said, no, we're going to contact the officer and we're going to set the court for another date. I said, uh-uh. That's a violation of due process law. You can't do that. She said, oh, yes, I can. Well, now you in treason.
Whoa.
You lose all immunities right now.
Yeah.
There is no evidence here. They're not even here. If you really want me to go that deep, can I call the city of Sheffield to the stand?
Whoa.
Can the city of Sheffield come to the stand and talk?
Mm.
Can the city of Sheffield say they've been personally injured?
Right, right.
You really want to go there? You know what I'm saying?
No,
like, you can't go there. Now, mind you, I just beat another traffic ticket. Because, now they took me to Sheffield to jail for that. And I still got the tickets from the state troopers at the county.
Okay.
I beat the case at the county, y'all.
Right.
That they gave me the tickets for no license, no tag registration. And, I had insurance. Mind you, I created my own insurance.
Right.
So,
wait, how did you do that?
It's easy. Make a bond. I made a bond with the trust. I gave the Social Security number to it, monetized my contract for a certain amount. That's it. It's done.
Man, people need to know about this. Come on now.
It's done.
What time is it? Look, we're going to get back. Hey, okay, look. We're going to take us a little break. How about that?
Okay.
We'll take us a little break. And Eric, man, you got to tell us more about this. I am blown away. I swear to God. But look, want y'all to stick around and stay tuned to more of the Andy Man Show right here on 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the show.
For the block, boy. Take it rough. It's been the same old thing on my block. You either working or you're slanging on my block. You had to hustle, that's how we was raised on my block. And you stayed on your hop until you made you a knot on my block. To hang out with the thing back then, and even when you left out, you came back in to my block from Holloway, Belfort to Scott. Reroll your flocks, we know the spots. Drank all the blue dots on your block. You probably bred a fat pad of Tupac, a big part of B.I. Your homeboys from knee high. And even when it was storming outside, that's me, dog, on my block. I ain't had to play the big shot. Knew me back when I was stealing beer from Shamrock, and my nickname was Creepy. If Black Joe could see me, he'd be tripping. I bet he still try to tease me. My block, everything is everything for Jeezy. My block, we probably done it all, homie, believe me. My block, we made the impossible look easy for Jeezy. I'll never leave my block, my niggas see me. My block, we ducking haters and the cops. I rock, we racing Pablo's chrome dot. On my block, it ain't no different than the next block. You get drunk and pass out, and they pack you to the hot. And when you wake up on the couch, you're going right back at it. On my block, when you daffing up, they laugh at it. On my block, just another day in the heart. On the south side of Houston, Texas, making your mark. On my block, with you and all the time, playing dominoes. Keep the swishing sweet down till my mama goes back inside. Then we can fly, passing around a few times. My block, everything is everything for cheesy. My block, probably done it all, homie, believe me. My block, we made the impossible look easy. My block, I'll never leave my block, my truth need me. My block, everything is everything for cheesy. My block, probably done it all, homie, believe me. My block, we made the impossible look easy. My block, I'll never leave my block, my truth need me. My block, everybody business ain't your business. What's going on in this house? Staying here, comprehending. My block, you had to have that understanding. Cause if you told Miss Maddie, she went and told Gladys. And with Bunchy Mama got it, it was all on the wire. And when the word got back, they said, you're fire. On my block, we got some non-fed shell shock. When the white got right, now they can help. On my block, it's like the world don't exist. We stay confined to this small little section we living in. On my block, I wouldn't trade it for the world. Cause I love these ghetto boys and girls. Born and raised on my block. Blah blah, everything is everything for cheesy. Blah blah, probably done it all, homie, believe me. Blah blah, you made the impossible look easy for cheesy. I'll never leave my block, my truth lead me. Blah blah, everything is everything for cheesy. Blah blah, probably done it all, homie, believe me. Blah blah, we made the impossible look easy for cheesy. I'll never leave my block, my truth lead me.
Shall not fear no man but God, though I walk through the valley of death. Please God, walk with me. Take me to heaven. Back in elementary, thrived on misery. Left me alone, I grew up amongst a dying breed. Inside my mind, couldn't find a place to rest. Until I got that thug life tatted on my chest. Tell me, can you feel me? I'm not living in the past, you wanna last. Be the first to blast, remember Cato. No longer with the seat, the seats. Call on the sirens, seen them murdered in the streets. Now rest in peace, is there heaven for a G? Remember me, so many homies in the cemetery. Shed so many tears.
I suffered through the years and shed so many tears.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, I lost so many pigs and shed so many tears.
Now that I'm struggling in this business by any means, label me greedy, getting green, but seldom seen.
The world, cause I'm cursed. I'm having visions of leaving here in the hearse. God, can you feel? Take me away from all the pressure and all the pain. Show me some happiness again. I'm going blind. I spent my time in the cell. Ain't living well. I know my destiny is hell. What did I fail? My life is in denial. And when I die, baptized in eternal fire, shed so many tears. Lord,
I suffered through the kings and shed so many tears.
Lord,
I lost so many tears and shed so many tears.
Now I'm lost and I'm weary. So many tears, I'm suicidal, so don't stand in me. My every move is a calculated step to bring me closer to embracing early death. Now there's nothing left. There was no mercy on the streets. I couldn't rest. I'm barely standing, about to go to peace and screaming peace. And though my soul was deleted, I couldn't see it. I had a mind full of demons trying to break free. They planted seeds and they had sparking the flame inside my brain like a match. Such a dirty game. No memories, just a misery. Painting a picture of my enemies killing me in my sleep. Well, I survive till the moon and to see the sun. Please Lord, forgive me for my sins, cause here I come.
Lord, I suffered through the years and shed so many tears.
God,
I lost so many tears.
And Lord knows I tried. Been a witness to homicides and drive-bys, taking lives, little kids die. When the wise I walk by, brokenhearted as I glance at the trunk line, getting high. This ain't the life for me. I wanna change, but ain't no future right for me. I'm stuck in the game. I'm trapped inside a maze. See the same array influence me. They're getting crazy, disillusioned lately. I've been really wanting babies, so I can see a part of me that wasn't always shady. Don't trust my lady. She's a product good as poison. I'm hearing noises. Think she's shitting on my boys. Can't take no more. I'm falling to the floor, begging for the Lord to let me into heaven's door. Shed so many tears. Lord,
I've lost so many kids and shed so many tears. I lost so many kids and shed so many tears.
Lord,
I suffered through the kids and shed so many tears.
FM, the music muscle of the shows. It is now 6:36, and you're tuned in to the Drive at 5. And of course, it's time for the Andy Main Show. I'm your host, Montrell, and I got my partner,
G-Main,
in the building. We got a special guest today, Mr. Eric Ingram Bay, and he is laying some game down. Shout out to everybody that's calling us up and letting us know that we are having a really good show. Well, if you don't have a chance to finish today or listen to us for the rest of the evening, make sure you go to YouTube, Knox Media Group, and you can check out our whole show in full. As a matter of fact, if you go to our YouTube page, search Knox Media Group, subscribe. And when you subscribe, leave your email address in the comments, and that'll give you an opportunity to win a car. And I did say a car. We will be giving away a car this year. So go to our YouTube page and subscribe straight up. So, Mr. Eric Bay, let's get into it, man. Again, like, where do we leave off? Because I got to hear all of this, man.
Talk about the money.
The money. Yeah, let's talk about that part.
Number one question. Where is
the money? Where's the money? Who paying your baby mama?
Yeah, everything paid out of trust now. So, you know, sure, the trust pay everything. But let's really talk about money. I don't think people really know what money is.
Okay.
I tell you, it's a show. It's a movie that was on Netflix called Laundromat.
Yeah.
The first 5 minutes tell you everything about money.
Right,
like it tell you everything what money is. Money is like in this system, money is bonds. Your money is contracts. Your contract is equivalent. Like say, if you got what you think is a loan, $100,000 loan, it's really equivalent to $100,000 in cash.
Okay.
Now I want you to think about this. If you take $100 right now and go to your bank, deposit it, that $100 bill is the same thing as a promissory note, as I was explaining earlier.
Okay.
It's a note, which means a promise to pay. So now they took the same thing that a promissory note represents. And they took it and they made a deposit. And on the liability side of the bank, they put that they owe you this amount of money, right?
Okay.
So in this, this is the same thing that happens when you get a loan, right?
Right.
They supposed to take that contract, because the truth is, like, I'm gonna show you, this is what's gonna blow your mind, bro.
Okay.
All right. You think by me handing this to you, like, I just handed that to you, right?
Okay.
Now, IRS want to know, what was the value of that?
Why do IRS want to know?
Because everything is in commerce. So what was the value of that transfer between my hand and your hand?
It was nothing.
Yeah, it was too.
What?
Yeah, it is. Whatever we want to put on it. So,
oh, okay.
So what I'm
okay.
telling you now, look at that. This is the loan. This is the contract, right?
Right.
So now the truth is, I sold you that note and you bought the note from me.
Oh, okay.
So now
okay.
this is called a what? Equal exchange. Remember, all money and contracts or anything that's circulating or considered as circulating as notes, your contracts circulate as a note within the banking system, right?
Okay.
Because it's being sold, and every person that sold was paid. So really, this is an exchange.
Okay.
So I don't owe you nothing. I gave you something of value in exchange for the equivalent, which was the credits, the money. But the truth is, they never gave you a check.
Okay.
You never received anything in your hand personally to do any of that, right?
Right.
You didn't.
So we're talking about making a deposit. So
that's the same thing.
Okay.
It's a deposit. So that money is deposited for you, but they're supposed to take that contract, and that contract was used as an investment security. So now, but remember, if you only operating as in your social security number, then guess what? You didn't claim it. But if you operating through that trust,
okay,
it's an asset to the trust.
Oh,
see what I'm saying?
Right.
And now all the investment goes back to the trust. So that means they have to set up an escrow account for you, just like a mortgage.
Okay. Okay.
So what's in escrow supposed to be paid to you, but you don't claim it. You left it. You abandoned it. You never supposed to abandon it. So they got what they call the 1099A, and it's
okay.
called making acquisition mm-hmm. on some form of property, or it could be somebody claiming it as something that was abandoned. If
okay.
you don't claim it, then they're going to claim it and say it was abandoned.
Okay.
So you need to make sure you claim every single contract and make acquisition on that, because it's an investment. And mm-hmm. it's also 1099B. This is a form of barter and trade.
Oh, okay. Okay.
But when you don't claim none of that stuff, everything's abandoned. Now, here's the thing. If you do claim it, you know what that means for these corporations?
What?
They got to pay 95% tax.
Oh, no. No,
nah, bro, I'm dead serious. They got to pay 95%.
Wow.
That's why it's called, what they call it, fractional reserve banking.
Okay. Yeah.
So in fractional banking, see, that's why it's called that, right? Because again, that 95%, like, they have to give up all of their money to the reserve, and they only able to keep so much in the bank. You see what I'm saying? That's
yeah,
the reason why
yeah.
you can't just go pull out. You have $500,000 in the bank, but you can't go pull it out of
right.
the day like that.
You right. can't just go pull it out.
You got to go audit.
Yeah, because exactly.
the bank technically don't have no money.
All right, so now how did the bank get money? Because they take your contract and they monetize it.
Okay.
So you give it.
So the bank will take your contract and
monetize it.
Okay. Okay. So they turn your money into money for them.
Right. They turn. Yeah. It's already money, because remember, you sold it first.
Okay.
We just think, and I'm talking about, it's literally as you sitting at that table, you sign it, and just like you slid it over, you thought that was nothing.
Okay.
Bro,
right.
You sold that contract.
Wow.
You sold it right then.
Yeah.
Remember, we got to think commerce. In commerce, yeah, that's what's happening. It's a transfer. So to transfer, meaning, and the only thing is, you do a blank endorsement. So we're not supposed to just be signing stuff. We're supposed to be putting pay to the order of who is going to then sign it. You see what I'm saying? And
okay.
then put without recourse. You can't recourse this debt back to me, because I gave you all rights and interest into this contract. So now you can't recourse the debt back to me. I'm not held
this
liable.
Is so hard for me to really believe.
Why? Because look, how
it makes sense though.
How is money printed? Contracts.
Right.
That's the reason why you can tell who sell drugs and who don't. Because again, if you don't got the receipts to back up with your contracts,
right.
where did the money come from?
Ah.
So now that's why every dollar is printed by contracts. So that's why I was telling G earlier, like, we co-mingling funds. You go to work.
Right.
You take that money you work for. And then you go take it and pay a bill. That's commingling, bro. It already got its funds. You see what I'm saying?
Preach, bro. Yeah.
You just can't abandon it. But our duty, now the job of the United States Treasury and the Federal Reserve is to manage the commerce. Well, how do they manage? By making sure it's enough money in the economy.
Right.
So
right.
When you look at the national debt, it's still going up. All that money, you know who that belonged to?
Who?
Us. Yes, you abandoned it, bro.
Yeah. We got to claim it.
We got to claim that money. That's why when the floodgates open up, everybody think that it's going to crash that way. No, that's not how it's going to crash.
Right.
It's not even really going to crash. It's just going to be so much money in the economy that's going to be put out there. It ain't even going to matter.
It's going to be worthless.
Yeah, you're just going to be worthless. You're going to throw that money in the street then.
Yep.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It won't mean anything.
It won't mean nothing.
Man.
But see, it's so everybody just keep abandoning their money. And that's why they say taxes is voluntary, because you state the status of the money.
Has anybody given you a hard time or try to, you know what I mean, like just mess with you because you know these things?
Man, I'm gonna say it like this. First and foremost, my life is in God's hand. That's right. How I move.
Okay.
Like, I don't fear none of this, because I'm telling you, because they go back to how I was raised and what I was taught. So I'm like, right. I got to see if this Bible is for real, what it's saying. And the only way I'm going to really experience that, if I step on out here in life in that aspect.
And put it to
in everything I do.
Right.
And okay. I did it, and it's real, bro.
So what would you encourage our listeners to do? Like first and foremost, right?
Get you a Black's Law Dictionary, like what you think a person is. You're not even a person. I'm people, but I'm not a person.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? It's a person automatically means corporation, fiction.
Okay.
That's your straw man.
Yeah. I'm people. I'm alive.
All right.
We're not a person. So get you a Black's Law Dictionary. Uniform commercial code, study that like you study your Bible, because if you really about your money, then I think you need to know about commerce, how exactly it works. And once you start reading that and understanding that,
how can I ask you this, as a business owner, you do business, you know what I mean, like, and everything is, do you do a business, like, you don't have to have a business license?
Nah, because I move by, like, if I do something, I do PMA and everybody acting as contractors.
Now, I did see you mention something about marijuana.
Right.
Once.
Right.
So how does that work?
That's my religion.
Okay. Okay.
You can't mess with that. You can't mess with my sacred practices. You can't even create a law for that.
Okay. All right.
You see what I'm saying?
But okay, explain that, because I'm a weed supporter. I'm an avid weed smoker.
Cannabis is like this, like, you know, we really have to realize, express your God-given right. God said what? Take part to partake in the herbs.
Right.
Or the land, let it be used for your healing, et cetera. That could be for mental, whatever.
Right.
See what I'm saying? So but it has to be a real practice. So the law says this.
Is that like being a Rastafarian? Is that?
I mean, it could be whatever, because listen to what I'm going to say. It could be whatever.
Okay.
Because
okay.
The law says liberty of conscience is that each individual has the right to decide what is religious to themselves.
Wow. So say that one more time for the people in the back.
Liberty of conscience means that each individual has the right to decide what is religious to themselves.
Okay.
So it's not even a particular religion that you even got to really, it's got to be your practice though.
Yeah.
So okay. Your culture that you in every, that's why I say the church was it for us. We just didn't utilize it right. Like when we gave, when we confessed our life to Christ, when we did all of that, like you became a member of a government. And it takes me back to the movie Sister Act. Why you think she kept running to the church? They couldn't get her.
Right.
They couldn't touch her as long as she was in that program. Right. When they kicked her out of it, what happened? They was able to try to arrest her, right?
Wow.
She got back in that program. So it showed a separation. But I'm going to say this. I know we cutting time, right?
Yeah, keep on going.
I'm going to say this. And this is real. For anybody that don't believe what I'm saying, I'm going to speak about the Amish community, which I really, you know, is very impressive what they do. But go read Wisconsin versus Yoder, 1972. So this ain't too far.
No, it's not too long ago.
We got family members.
Okay.
They're still alive from that time, right?
Really? Yes.
1972, right? So in that time, remind you, any statute that a state create is considered law.
Right. Okay.
And we think it's got to be followed to the T.
Yeah.
Well, these parents, they decided that they took that, like they had a law where the kids had to go to school to a certain age, right?
Okay.
And they religion said, like, no, they took the children out of the school. And, you know, they were arrested for it and everything like that. But they won because their religion required them to be set apart from the world. And they actually won their case. They was acquitted from everything. Their children were able to go home into their own schooling based upon their religion.
Yeah.
When I read that, bro, that right there done it for me.
Do you do homeschooling?
And not really, because as of right now, like my older daughter, she's in Atlanta. And then, of course, you know, that's two separate homes right now, whatever. But there will be a time when I think, I don't do it right now because I believe in socialism. So they need to socialize with other children.
I agree with that.
So at a certain time when they're ready, then I'll pull them out to be ready for what I got to say now.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes,
so,
yes. So your wife now, like, she listens to, she's.
My wife, great. She came
I
in.
Know, like, I
and
think.
She jumped in and there's no questions with me.
See, that's awesome. Me and G-Man was talking about having great wives. I mean, a lot. You know what I mean? Like. Right. To actually listen and motivate you and encourage you to help people and to do more. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I think that's great. You always got to have someone behind you.
She's the reason why I'm doing it on this level.
Because you stepped it up. Like, I see, like, I want you to be back. I want you to let people know how to reach you. If they want to know more, how to let them know how to find you.
Eric Ingram Bay on Facebook and on TikTok. It's MNRP. 619-2020, and then on Instagram is Moorish National Republic of Peace.
And he will come and speak with you personally. He'll come and speak to your group. I'm sure y'all hit him up, man, and he'd be glad to come and just give you this information that we all should know. I am looking sideways at myself now because I don't know what I'm gonna do. Like, I'm hold up now. I'm trademarking my name, like, straight up, like,
get
all
your
that
trust.
Give me, hey man,
do it,
bro. You didn't.
That's what people be. Hey, that's what people be talking about Trump all the time. Like, cause Trump got trust,
right?
Yeah,
and trust is a whole. Hey, you play by a whole different set of rules when you're in trust, man.
That's why Trump put his own value on stuff.
So let me say this: stop burying y'all people in cemeteries and bury them on your land, please.
Oh, yeah. Man, what made you say it? Because Trump did that.
Because when you do that, it's sacred, and they can't separate you from their land no more. Your blood, your DNA, your whole lineage is connected to the land now.
Really?
Now they can't foreclose on your house, none of that no more. Yeah, that's
no
over
more
with.
Property tax, none of that.
Yeah, that's over with, bro. It becomes sacred, remember?
Man, mama!
You feel me?
My spot in the backyard.
Hey, that's where I'm being buried at.
Man, that's crazy. Look, man, Trump buried his wife on the golf course.
Ain't it mine?
Hey, gangsta.
It's demanded that you have to bury me on the land where I was raised, yo.
And ain't nothing wrong with that. I think that, like, they used to do that back in the day. Absolutely. See, look, I think when they put that new Walmart, they dug up so many people.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So what happens when everybody actually give everything to the church? You give your land and everything to the church, and the church give it back to you in equity. Now you ain't got to pay no taxes. Now the church, everything is under the church law, your land. Like, now they can't just walk up in there and tell you, check your IDs on your, like y'all saying, what happened to them people. They can't do that now. Because now you under a different law, bro. That's what I'm saying. We was really supposed to, like, it was a trick question, bro. When the devil tried to say, I'll give you all of this if you come serve and bow down to me. And it's like, what you got to give?
Yeah.
It belongs to me.
I already own it.
Right. Yeah, God, yeah.
God
I'm
already
the son.
Gave me this.
He already gave me this. Like, that's a trick question. So it's the same situation. What do they own, bro? They don't own nothing. We just giving everything just away.
Yeah.
Stop giving it away, man. Really trust God, y'all. That's my message, man. Right. Really stand on that.
Man. It's been a blessing to have you on the show, man.
We got to have you back, man.
We got to have you
anytime,
back.
Anytime I'm here for y'all. Y'all my uncles to me. So you know,
hey,
I'm here.
I love what you're putting out there in the atmosphere, man. And I think more people need to hear it. We're going to stay in touch with you for sure. And I'm going to have you back at least once a month, if that's okay.
Oh, hey, I'm with that.
You come sit with us and just have your topics that, you know what I mean? That,
whatever.
That way we ain't got to try to touch everything all at one time.
Well, whatever the feedback from the people, what they want to talk about next,
that's what we'll talk about.
Yeah, get the people what they want.
Sounds good to me, man. We really appreciate you, Eric, man. Looking forward to having you back. G-Man, thank you for reaching out to him. You know, oh, like yeah, you said,
man.
It's like
it was time, man.
I've been around him all my, like most of his life. You know what I mean?
Hey, I remember back when he was the Fresh Prince. I done seen him come a mighty long way, man. So, hey, to see where you come from and where y'all now, man, it's just a blessing, man.
It is.
I love you, man. And,
yeah.
Hey, man, keep doing what you're doing, man.
Appreciate it, man.
And that's a great thing, teaching people something that they really can use as right. good. Because I ain't going to lie, that child support, bro, that thing had me in a stronghold straight up. Still got me in a stronghold pretty much.
Well, let's show the people. That way you can tell them what's up.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
I'll do it for you.
On everything. Man, we're going to talk about it like straight up. Hey, look, y'all have a great, great weekend, man. It's going to be a lot of stuff going on this weekend. Of course, they are having the induction into the Burrell Slater Hall of Fame tonight up at the Coach Mitchell Gym. So if y'all can get out and go up there and have you a good time. And I'm going to be out in these streets this weekend, I guess. So make sure y'all holler at your boy. Want y'all to stick around and stay tuned to more music right here on 105.1 FM, the music muscle of the shows. Boy, you playing that quick.
Quick, man. Here we go.
A day in the life of a player named Quick. I'm just a stubborn kind of fella with a head like a brick. And just because I think that, hey, they say that I'm hopeless. But I don't really care, so blame it on the locals. Now this is how we do it when we checking the grip. Player hammers in the house, so don't even trip. We're busting funky compositions, as smooth as a prism. So check it while I kick it to this funky dope rhythm. It's Friday morning, the phone is ringing off the hook. And AMG is in the dealer, viewing rhymes in this notebook. Or should I say dope sack, because we don't bust whack. I pick up the phone and it's the G.
What's up?
He said he's coming down at about 2 on the dot. So I'm about to rest a tub, but my water's still hot. And now I'm soaking. A brother like the devastating DJ Quick and joke. You'll mess with me and suck and see that they get broken. My name is Quick, but you can call me Daddy. Yo, open up the duck and seek a freak man in a cat. Now freaky's in the L, dog and shabby's in the L. Go, and everybody's sipping on the quote.
Here we go.
DJs came with a 40 and a quote. In addition to the 3 that Greedy just bought. But I don't want to start early, so I just might put my 40 in the freezer because I want to get fit.
Tonight is the
night. Yo, when we gon'
get
fit?
Tonight is the
night. Oh yeah. And now I'm out of the tub, I'm feeling fancy free. Spray out some Xerius and put my keep on sheet. Sweatsuit, the gray one with the burgundy trim. And it's a medium fit me proper cause I'm nice and slim. 5:30 on the clock and the sun is steadily sinking. And I'm still thinking about the egg that I'll be drinking. You know I ain't ashamed and you know I ain't bashful. So gonna pop the 40 so I can put me a glass full. Hammer's in the bedroom and he's fading a stick. So fatter than a pinky and the length of a pencil. Freaky got the girl, he's coming 1, 2, 3. And the one with the green eyes is coming with me.
It's the bomb.
Yo, I can feel her body.
Get numb.
Yo, forget that 40 out.
It's a rum.
I'm chilling like
damn,
a villain.
Here I come.
And that's how I'm living. Tonight is the night and I'm looking real sporty. Proper Friday evening and I'm ready to party. Crazy came in with a handful of snaps. Let's shoot some crap.
You're listening to WMXV HD3, St. Joseph, Tennessee, and 105.1 W286 DV, Florence, Alabama. You're listening to WMXV HD3, St. Joseph, Tennessee, and 105.1 W286 DV, Florence, Alabama.
It's time for a moment in Black history. 1992, Mae Jemison is the first Black woman in space. In 1987, Mae Jemison, an engineer and physician, became the first Black woman to be admitted into NASA's astronaut training program. Just over 5 years later, she flew into space above the Endeavor, becoming the first Black woman in space. Did you know that?
Knox Media Group weather. Download our apps today. Music Muscle of the Shoals 105.1 FM and WKAX 1500 AM. It's currently 69 degrees. The forecast for this evening, clear skies with a light breeze, 54 degrees. Overnight, cloud-free and somewhat breezy, temperature 46. And then tomorrow, clear skies with a light breeze, the temp 76. On Sunday, partly cloudy, temp around 79. We are the Knox Media Group, Music Muscle of the Shoals, 105.1 FM and WKAX 1500 AM, bringing you the beats and the weather on the go.
You are in the mix with the station that loves you really strongly and makes you feel the love.
105.1 FM, the Music Muscle of the Shoals.
Double XL, higher level radio.
High profile.
Put your hands up high. Put your hands up high.
Yo, DJ.
Giving you all the hottest hip hop and R&B.
Drake, this is Meek Mill, Chris Brown.
Hey, this is Rihanna.
Let go.
We got your nice lit.
We got a lit.
And it's kicking off right now.
What's popping? What's crackling?